The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 24 through 26, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in December of 1966 in New York.
Aham hi sarvajagyana, bhukta cha prahurevacha, natumam abhijananti, tattena tatsavantite. Because you do not know God in fact, simply understanding, oh, there is God. And little more advanced, God is our order supplier. Oh, that is not sufficient. You must know God. Oh, and I need to say, tattena, in truth, tattena. That tattena, in truth, as it is explained by Lord Chaitanya, that is the highest explanation. He has given the fullest information. Of course, it is not possible to understand God to the fullest extension. But as far as possible, as a human being can understand, that has been explained by Lord Chaitanya about Krishna. Krishna has explained in the Bhagavad Gita about himself, that is more than sufficient, and still more Lord Chaitanya has explained about him. Krishna has explained himself that he requires to surrender unto him. Just like here also he says, the Aham hi sarvajagyanam bhukta. I am the beneficiary of all the activities of living entity. Bhukta cha prahudeva. I am enjoyer and I am the master. So, in the Bhagavad Gita you will find that the Lord advises people in general, the sarva dharman parityajyamami kamsaranam. Just try to surrender unto me and I shall give you all protection. Then, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is also Krishna himself, as a devotee, he is explaining Krishna further. Not only surrender, but after surrender, what are the activities? That is explained by Lord Chaitanya. So, for the general, people in general, the first requisition is that they must learn how to surrender unto God. Tattena nate abhijananti. They do not know what is an accurate situation of the Supreme Lord. Now, here it is stated, janti deva vrata devan pitrin janti pitri vrataha bhutani janti bhutejya janti madhyadi ma. Now, the argument that in whatever form you worship the Supreme, this is the Mayavadi theory, that God is impersonal. Now, because we cannot worship or meditate upon something impersonal, therefore let us imagine something about Him and meditate upon that. Just like the impersonalist yogi, they put before them a lump of something and concentrate upon them. So, here, that theory is refuted by Krishna. That impersonal conception of the Supreme and our imagination of God, that is not the way of approaching God. He says clearly here, Janti Deva Vrata Deva. Those who are worshipping the demigods have their different places in this material world. All the planets, heavenly planets, there are seven planetary systems up and seven planetary systems down. So, this is called Bhuloka, earthly planet. and there are many planets on this system. So Bhuloka, Bhuvarloka, Janoloka, Tapoloka, then Brahmaloka, Sattaloka, like that. So many planets there. So there are different kinds of living entities and different kinds of comfort. They are highly intelligent, more intelligent than the human being. Therefore they are called demigods, almost gods. So here Krishna says, those who are trying to the demigods, they will go to the planets of the demigods. Janti deva vrata deva. Pitrin janti piti vrata. Piti vrata, there is a form of worship of the forefathers. So there is a particular planet, the worshipper of the forefathers will go there. Pitrin janti piti vrata. And bhutejya janti, bhutani janti bhutejya. And those who are materialistic, those who want to worship these earthly things in this material, not material world everywhere, but bhutejya especially, material worship. So bhutejya, those who are worship of material elements, they go to they remain in the material platform. Janti majjajino pi ma. And those who are worshipping me, Lord, they will come to me. This is very nice, clear. Now suppose, if you have purchased ticket for an intermediate station between California, San Francisco and New York. So, have to get down in that station. So how can you expect that you have purchased a ticket for intermediate station, how can you expect to go to California? Similarly, if you worship demigods, you can go up to that planet. As you worship, there are different arrangements in the system, in the creation of God. As you want, you have got freedom of action and God awards you the result, whatever you want. But if you want to go to the planet where Krishna is, Krishna planet, which is called Goloka Vrindavan, then you have to worship Krishna. So there is nothing unreasonable. If you want to go to California or San Francisco, you have to purchase tickets for that. Now, what is the difference between going to other planets and to the planet where Krishna is? That is explained. That is explained in a different place that Jadgatyana Nivartante Tadhama Paramanama. The supreme platform, supreme planet is there, where going, nobody returns to this material world. Jadgatyana nivartante. Nivartante means does not nivartante, does not return. Abramba bhubana lokan purada avastina. That is already we have discussed, that gatavati. Now within this material world, even if you go to the higher planet, the planet of the moon, planet of the sun, planet, heavenly planet, the Indra Lok, Chandra Lok, so many there. Then, after finishing your result of past activities, you have to come back again. Punaravarti. So, we are sometimes going up, sometimes coming back again in this material, sometimes going down. Just like we are changing different dresses. Sometimes I have got this body, Indian, sometimes you have got this body, American, and sometimes I may get the body of a dog or a hawk or something else, I may get the body of demigod. As these changes of races are going on, cycle of birth and death, transmigration of the soul in different forms of life. Similarly, there is transmigration of the soul in different planets. So, Abramma Bhuvana Lokan these system of going up and down should be stopped. That is the business of an intelligent person. Yadagatana nivartante. We should try to go to that planet. We are going, no more coming back. That is Krishna law. That is Vaikuntha, the spiritual star. Parastasmasu bhavahanna. Beyond this material sky, there is spiritual sky, there are spiritual planets, and Krishna loka is here. So, Krishna gives here hints that madhujajinopi ma, as others are going, trying to go in other planets. Similarly, those who are in Krishna consciousness, those who are absolutely worshipper of the Supreme Lord, they will come to me. They will come to me. Mamupetta Kauntiya, in other place, there are several places mentioned this fact. Mamupetta Kauntiya, Dukhalam Asasatam Nathnubanti Mahatmana Sangsiddhim Lavatipara. Those who attain once to me, they will never to come again to this place of misery. So here is the hint that by Krishna consciousness, if we remain always in Krishna consciousness, then our transference to that planet of Krishna Loka is guaranteed. Jangjang Matismaran Loki Tajattam Vikalevaram. We have discussed this verse that at the time of death, my mental condition, whatever my mental condition is at that time, at the time of my death, I am just going to have a similar body according to the mental condition at the time of my death. So, if we are constantly engaged in Krishna, transcendental loving service of Krishna, Krishna consciousness, then naturally we shall be thinking of Krishna at the time of death. This is the practice. This is the practice. Sadatada bhava bhant. Unless you practice, just like if you have to play, and the stage, you have to perform several years, or if you have to appear in some examination, then you prepare yourself what sort of question may be there. And so, similarly, if we at all want to transfer ourselves to that planet, Krishna Loka, Chintamani Dham, then we have to practice. We have to practice. In this life, this human form of life is meant for practicing. Just like apprentice. Those who are even apprentice, they are already liberated. Because that's a nice student who is preparing himself. He is already passed. Passed means he is preparing himself in such a nice way that his passing of the examination is guaranteed. Similarly, if we the trouble of becoming Krishna conscious always, then our transference to that planet, Madhyajinopi Moth, that is guaranteed. Bhutani Janti Bhuteja, Janti Madhyajinopi Moth. Now the question is that Krishna consciousness, how to perform Krishna consciousness? That is explained by the Lord in the next verse. Patram puspam phalam soyam jumi bhakta prajacchati tadaham bhakti bhakti upahitam asnami prajatatmana. Now you have to make friendship with Krishna. Just like if you want to go to see somebody very great, then somehow or other you have to make some connection with him. Something. If you have to introduce yourself in a way, in a friendly way, in a loving manner, then it is possible to make connection with great personalities. So, if we want to transfer ourselves to that supreme planet, Krishna Loka, then we have to prepare ourselves how to love Krishna, love of God. if we are intimately in touch with God by love, we cannot conquer with or we cannot claim any favor from the Supreme unless we are in love. The love means there are six principles of loving. What is that? Dadati, Pratignati, Bhunte, Bhojayate, Guiham, Akhyati, Prichati, Cha, Saravidha, Priti Lakshanam. How one can understand, I love you, or you can understand that I love you. There are six kinds of reciprocation. Six kinds of exchange, reciprocation. What is that? Dadati. One whom you love, you must give something. And you must take something from him. Dadati Padajinda. Bhunte Bhojayate. You must give him something to eat. And you must accept also what he gives to eat. Dadati Pratignati Bhunte Bhojayate Gujjam Akshati Prichyatisa. You must disclose your mind and you must hear him if your lover is also in some difficulty, he discloses his mind. So these six things, Dadati giving and Pratignati accepting and Bhunte to offer foodstuff and accept foodstuff and disclose your mind and hear him also. These six. So we have to deal with God in that way. Therefore, if you want to offer something, the beginning is offering. Offering. We must offer something. So what is that offering? If somebody says that I am very poor man, I cannot offer anything. Because in India, of course, offering to the demigods, offering to some deity, there is very expensive job, there are beasts of goods. Now suppose a poor man, he wants to offer something to God, then what he has to offer? Here is a prescription given by the Lord himself, which can be offered even by the poorest man. What is that? Patram puspam phalam toyam. A little bit of tulsi leaf, or any leaf, puspam, a little bit of flower, patram, puspam, phalam, a small fruit, and soyam, a little water. Now patram, puspam, phalam, soyam, these four things can be available universally. Nobody is so poor that he cannot collect a leaf of a tree, or a small fruit, or a small flower, a little water. It is universal. Nothing expensive. So anyone, in any country, in any place, he can offer Krishna these four things. There is no bar. Patram, puspam, phalam, toya. Four things. A small leaf, you can have any. There are so many trees. If you take one leaf, even if you are forbidden, if you ask, I am going to offer this leaf to God, anyone will offer it. Patram, puspam, a little flower, and a small fruit, a little water. So, Lord said, patram, puspam, phalam, tuyam, jume bhakta prajacchati. The real thing is love. Anyone who is offering me these four things in love, Taya bhaktya upahitam, because he has brought these four things with love and devotion, then God says, tadaham asnami, I eat, bhakta pradita-atmana, because with devotion, with faith, and with love, he has brought, God is full. We should not think that God is depending upon my this little flower or fruit. He is very hungry when I shall offer this fruit and he will satisfy. No, he is full now. But the quality